And I'm a nursing assistant here on 7 East. I've been here for about 12 years on July 6th, so it's been quite a while. And 7 East IMCU is my home unit. I really enjoy it here. What I enjoy most about working at Swedish is coming to work and having a great work family. I come here, I feel comfortable, I feel safe, and I feel confident in taking care of my patients to make sure that they get the best possible care that I can provide. Swedish has been a great employer to me, and I feel very lucky to have been here as long as I have because it's a great community. You know, there's so many specialties, and I really, really enjoy coming to work. What patient-centered care value means to me is coming into work in the morning and seeing my patients and kind of knowing what is it that I can do to help them feel better. Whether that's getting them up to the chair, taking them for a walk, brushing their teeth, washing their face, interacting with their family. I think I'm here for one reason, and that's to take care of people. That's what I feel I'm good at. That's what I love to do. So coming and, you know, being recognized in that way really means a lot to me.
คอยเฮ็ดเวียกทําความสะอาดอยู่ห้องหมอนี่โดยความบริสุทธิ์ใจเฮ็ดโดยความสะอาดหมดทุกมลเฮ็ดผ่านมาได้ 6 ปีผ่านมาแล้วคอยเฮ็ดเวียกอยู่ห้องหมอนี่คอยรู้สึกว่าดีใจหลายเพราะว่า คอยมีความสมิสนันในการทําความสะอาดในบ่อนห้องหมอก็เป็นบ่อนสําคัญที่สุดสําหรับคนเจ็บและคนทุกๆคนทั่วไปขอบใจหลังจากคอยได้รับใบย่องย่อสรรเสริญจากท่านหมอและทุกๆเจ้าหน้าที่คอยก็รู้สึกดีใจหลายเพราะว่าคนใน สารเสริญและย่องย่อคอยว่าคอยเฮ็ดดีทำความสะอาดดีในห้องหมอนี่คอยก็รู้สึกดีใจหลายและคอยก็ขอบมุกขอบใจนำทุกๆท่านที่ให้ความอุดหนุน Thank you ขอบใจ
I'm Christina Gambinski and I am a secretary at Swedish First Hill in the ICU and I've worked here for 15 years. I started off here as a nursing assistant at Swedish and worked my way up. And I was cross-trained as a HUC about 5 years ago and started in the ICU in 2011. What I enjoy most about working at Swedish is the sense of that we are a family here, and I really like taking care of patients and helping their families to get through like a difficult time. It's really scary here in the ICU, and you know, if I can help them in any way to, you know, get through this situation, anything I can do to help them, even if it's just like getting them coffee or a cot or giving them directions to a hotel, you know. That makes me feel good that I've helped them. So I really am like a helper, you know, I like taking care of people. So that's one of the main things that I like about Swedish, you know, being able to help everyone. Teamwork and partnership to me means being able to help out anywhere at work when I come into work during the day. I do have a nursing assistant background, so I am able to help out with patient care on the floor if a nurse needs help turning a patient or taking someone to the bathroom. I don't mind jumping in there. I wear scrubs to work every day. I don't normally dress like this, so I'm very comfortable working with patients. Obviously not comfortable in front of this camera, but so it feels good to help out on the floor.
My name is Nathan Price. I've been here at Swedish since 2003, and I work at First Hill in the ICU. The thing I really enjoy most, gives me the most joy, is my coworkers, and I think actually just, you know, having the time with them, being at the bedside, knowing that we all have the similar skill set, that we all have the same knowledge base, really helps me to feel comfortable when I come to work, and when I wake up in the morning, I'm happy to be, you know, going to Swedish because I know we give first-class service. Continuous learning and improvement, I think, really kind of means for me engagement and retention for me. So I think that, you know, having, you know, kind of came out of nursing school in 2000, I was really fired up and I had a lot of energy and I was super excited to be a nurse. And I think, you know, my honeymoon lasted for 4 or 5 years, but by 2005 I found myself, I was, you know, here at Swedish for the last couple of years, and I was wondering, well, what else is there? What else can I possibly do? I mean, I was feeling a little bit disconnected, kind of plateaued, but what I really feel, you know, that kind of got me was the manager at the time, it was June Alteras, decided that she was going to take bedside nurses and create a committee so that they could kind of create changes on policy and procedure and how it related to making things work at the bedside. So I really found that to be intriguing, and I kind of jumped on that, being a nurse at Swedish and knowing that we were giving really great care. It kept me engaged so that I would develop more skills. I became a certified ICU nurse, which also being a preceptor was very important to me. I think that you know, being able to kind of give back and to see someone else grow is something that's very important, and something that just sort of like breathes life into your own profession. You can look at it and think, wow, you know, I see that person coming along and I remember what it was like to be there, and sometimes it really makes you remember why you started doing it to begin with. And if you can offer them a really good start, I think that's rewarding.
Hi, my name is Mark Bustamante. I'm a senior application analyst on the CIS department, and currently I'm a member of the informatics inpatient emergency department team. I started working at Swedish in early 2000 as a nurse traveler working in the intensive care unit on the First Hill campus. A few years later, I signed on as a staff nurse in the ICU float pool, or at that time it was called the flex pool. In 2010, I transitioned into the CIS department and eventually moved into my current position. What I've enjoyed the most about Swedish was the people, or are the people I've worked with. There's some amazing people that I've had the privilege of working with through my various roles and jobs at Swedish. Many of them have been extremely skilled in their disciplines and fields. I feel that they really care about the people and patients that they've worked with. Really, I wouldn't be as successful as I am in my current role without a lot of the people I work with. I am extremely honored to be receiving the Niels Johansen Leadership Award. Leadership has less to do with an individual achievement and more of a reflection or measure of what a team has accomplished. Members of the informatics, my informatics team, initially nominated me for the MVP, which led to the Niels Johansen Award. I feel that the nomination, or the words used in the nomination ballots, could easily be used to describe each of them. And I feel that each of them are just as deserving, if not more so than I. I feel that a lot of the projects I've worked on really would not have been accomplished. And even the projects I'm currently working on, I really look to the members of my team to help in terms of coordinating the completion of the project, as well as their own insight and expertise in completing the project. It's not a one-person team. It's a collaboration with not just my members of my team, but with other members of the CIS team that gets a lot of the work done. And so at times I feel humbled by the fact that I'm the one being recognized for this award, and whereas there's a lot of other folks that should be, I'm humbled by the gesture of those on my team, and I'm just blessed to be working with those people side by side every day.